Hey everybody, thanks for watching. I got a lot of comments in my last video concerning what accessories I use. So I thought I'd take a minute to go through everything that I use and kind of share a little bit of my workflow. Everything you see here fits in this little bag right here. So that's the first thing I want to talk about is the bag that I carry it around with. This is the Tonbin Side Effect. And it only costs about 50 bucks. Tonbin is a great company. It's one of my favorite bag companies. I've used this for like probably the last 2 years. Now that I have the TCL X100 teleconversion lens, it's a really tight fit with this and this. So I'm actually looking for a different bag. If you have any bag recommendations, let me know and I will try to find them and maybe even do a review of those bags. The first thing I want to talk about is the teleconversion lens. This is the, I believe it's called the TCL X100, and it's about $350. Now, this is the first version of it. When Fuji released the new X100F, they also released the, like the second version of this. Now, it's the same glass, but the only difference is there's a little magnet on here that tells this camera that it's the 50, that there's a 50 millimeter equivalent teleconversion lens on here, and it does all the changes in here. This teleconversion lens, I love this. This has changed the way I shoot because I don't like shooting portraits with the 35 millimeter field of view. This extends it to a 50 millimeter equivalent field of view in a 35 millimeter format, of course, and I love the image quality with this. I don't feel like there's any degradation in it, and yeah, it's great. It makes my system, I feel like, more complete, because I do shoot portraits fairly often, and now I feel like this can be my go-to camera for almost all situations. And that's because of this teleconversion lens, and that's the, again, TCL X100. Another question that I got in my videos was, how do I keep my lens safe? Because I don't use a lens cap, and the way that I do that is through the, I think it's a 49 millimeter UV haze clear filter, okay? Now, I haven't been able to find any discernible difference between images when it's on or off. So what this does is essentially keeps my lens, the actual glass on this camera, safe from scratches. And I love that because I'm always shooting with it. I would have lost the lens cap 100 times over, but this was on my X100T. Same thing fits on the X100F. Now, don't go and just buy this. You have to buy the adapter that comes with the, what is it, the lens hood, goodness gracious. This is the JJC lens hood with the adapter. And so what that does, this attaches, this can attach just to this by itself. You have to have the adapter. Now, what that adapter does, also, you can see that there's probably like 4 or 5 millimeters, but there's a considerable distance that it gives between the edge of this and then the actual lens. So if I were to just put this on the Fuji system without an adapter, the focusing would actually, because the lens extends in and out, it would not allow it to extend all the way out and you'd get a focus error, so you wouldn't be able to use your camera. Get the adapter, then put the filter on, or if you want to do it the way I do, then you can put the filter on. I mostly shoot with it just like this. The clear UV haze filter is about $20, and the adapter and lens hood, they come together. That was like, what, $13? Come on, $13. It's only $13, and you get a hood, adapter, and for an extra $20, you get the filter that's gonna protect your lens. So that's a pretty good deal. Next thing is the soft shutter release, right here. Just a little bitty red soft shutter release button. I bought the $20 version of it. That's kind of, it's a little bit thicker. It looks a little bit more premium. I got it on Amazon. I think it was like 25 bucks. I can't remember the brand of it, but after about 3 or 4 months of using it, and I'm talking about on my X100T system, after using it for about 3 or 4 months, I lost it. So I was like, I'm not gonna spend 20 bucks again just to lose it, because they kind of do get loose. So I found on Amazon for $7, I bought two of these for $7, not each, for both of them. And it's essentially the same thing. The link to all the stuff, by the way, is in the description. So if you wanna see where to buy it, where I bought it, the link is in the description. So this, I've heard one YouTuber, what's the YouTuber's name? He does like 10 videos a day about Fuji cameras, which is fine by me. I'll link to it right here what his name is and what his channel is. But anyway, he was talking about how he has heard, and I've heard since then, about how this is like a really soft LCD panel. And what I mean by that is when I turn it on, I can actually see like my fingerprint and like the liquid crystal display, like the liquids in it moving around. So that's not really good. It's kind of a wimpy screen. I mean, it's not like I'm banging that around, but it would be good to put a screen protector on it. And I have a glass screen protector. It's pretty nice. And that cost, let's see here, that was $9. Again, off Amazon. That was a JJC GSPX 100T tempered glass protector. And I posted that on Fuji X100 Facebook group, and somebody commented that that doesn't fit, it's not the right fit, it doesn't work. I don't know what they're talking about. It works perfectly. It fits exactly where you'd want it to fit on your X100F, even though it says X100T. So don't worry about that. It does fit. And again, the link is in the description. Okay, yeah, the next thing that I am going to talk about is the Sony, what is this called? Sony ICD-UX533 recorder. It's just a little recorder that I like to keep around with me. So when I'm out shooting on the street or doing interviews with students out on campus for my day job, I like to have this on me. So if I run into somebody, if I'm gonna do their portrait or interview them, I don't have to pull my phone out to do the little voice memo thing. I can just use this. And this is really nice. It's got a really simple menu system, and I can say I have a folder for vlog, then I have a folder for street photography, and then for We Are Sooners, which is the thing that I would do here on campus. So it's really nice, it's easy to use. It's about $110, it's pretty good quality. You can put a lavalier mic into this and put it in somebody's pocket, but I just use it basically just to interview, for interviews of strangers or students out on campus, and it helps me get their quotes right if I'm going to quote them. And it's super small. There's a lot of these out there, but I like this one because it's super small. The next thing that I'm going to talk about is the charging cable. Pretty simple. But what I love about the X100T and this is that you can use your USB to USB mini USB-C. I don't know what this is called, what this end one is called. But you can plug this baby into your Fuji camera and it'll charge the battery inside it. So that's handy because I only have one, as of now, I only have one battery for this camera. So I keep my charger, my battery charger on my desk. So I can plug it in all the time and I'll have this with me almost always. So that way if I'm in the car, I can plug it in and charge it in my car, or if I'm at my house, I can plug it in and charge it there through like a little iPhone dock. Next thing I wanna talk about, I wish I could talk about it more. I'm actually gonna do a video about this later, but these are the flash cue triggers. And again, I found out about this from that same guy I mentioned earlier. He's a YouTuber, talks about Fuji gear all the time. Again, his link is somewhere around here. I can't remember his name or his YouTube channel, I'm sorry. But as soon as I saw him put this on the camera, I bought it immediately. This allows you, it's a quick trigger. It's called the, hold on, let me get you the name. It's called the Flash Cue Trigger Kit from Lightpix. It's a Lightpix Flash Cue Trigger Kit. And this enables me to do high speed sync with the X100F. It's amazing. And look at that, it's so small. You know, you typically see them, they're like this big. And I wasn't gonna, like, I'm not gonna deal with that. I don't want something like that. It's this big on an X100 T or F, you know, so. This is manageable, this is doable. I can put it in my pocket, like literally. Yeah, I love it. So that's that, it's pretty small. Again, I don't use it all the time. I'm gonna start using it more for my photo shoots I do with students on campus on occasion. But yeah, the Flash Cue Triggers by FindPix. That was, how much was that? That was, another thing, it's only $55. It's $55, so you can't go wrong there. So I'm gonna be doing a video about the X100F and high speed sync using these quick triggers probably the next couple months. So if you wanna see that, subscribe to my channel. That'll let me know to go ahead and make that video and to put some effort into it. So I use the Fuji app from time to time if I want to do, if I wanna get photos off this to my phone or to my iPad. I'll use this if I wanna do multiple photos so it doesn't take as long as doing it just via Wi-Fi. But I mean, 95% of the time I'm using Lightroom to edit my photos, but there's the occasional time when I want to edit something mobily. That's when I'll use the Wi-Fi, or I'll use this if I want to do more than, you know, a few on my iPad or iPhone. And this was, I think this at the time was $60 because it's Apple and they're always expensive, but I think you can buy it for like $30 now. I also use Snapseed to edit on my iPhone and my iPad. It's a sweet app, it's free, and yeah, it's a great app. I would suggest using Snapseed. Also, if you have any suggestions for photo editing apps for iPhone or iPad, let me know in the comments. I'd love to hear what you are using. Okay, so this is like the main setup that I have right now. All this, again, can fit in my bag, but I have a couple things coming. The first thing is I am making a custom hardwood grip for the X100F. Now, when I had my X100T, I actually made two custom hardwood grips. I made one that was out of like softwood, like lump, like just like 2x4 lumber that you can get at Lowe's. Cut it up, made it, it worked pretty well. It wasn't like the most beautiful thing ever, but it did its job. And then I made a second one that was much better quality. And yeah, it was great. I ended up selling that one when I sold the X100T on eBay because the X100T is 1 millimeter smaller than this, and I didn't know if it would be able to fit the X100F. So the last thing I want to talk about is the camera strap. Now, right now I have the Fuji standard strap that comes with the camera. It's not very good. It seems kind of cheap. I'm actually surprised how cheap it is considering that it's a $1,200 camera, $1,300 camera. There's a man in Oklahoma City that makes leather goods, and I reached out to him and said, hey, can you make a leather strap with these dimensions? And so he said yes, and so I'm waiting on that. I'm excited to see what comes of it. He's never made a camera strap before, so we'll see how it looks. When I get the leather camera strap, I will do an official review of it and then post it on here as well. Let's see here, I'm gonna show you how it all fits in here, okay? There we go, everything's in there. Thanks for watching. If you have any suggestions for bags that would be good for the X100F and a teleconversion lens with maybe like a few little trinkets as well, let me know. What else, is that it? I think that's it. Yeah, thanks for watching.